Cause I know we have the shape of things to come.
It's a real passion for me, being able to actually build circuits and understand how they work, testing and measuring and stuff. I found I learned a lot more from that than I did studying GCSE physics and studying electronics in that for 2 years, where I never actually touched or saw a circuit. The tutors here, they are really interactive and they're always there, even outside of lessons, whenever you need something. We don't go around calling everyone sir, miss, second names. We use first names for everything, and there's a more relaxed and friendly communication between the tutors and the students.
Before I came to Leeds City College, I was in school, I was in such a bad way of school. Skiving lessons all the time, teachers always on my case, getting kicked out numerous times almost, and then, so I applied for here, just hoping to get on a course. I got accepted, but it was on entry level 3. Dave was my tutor, and I couldn't have asked for anyone better as a tutor because he just helped me and helps me with every regard with maths and English. Workshop work, the theory side of the workshop work, and that telling me how everything is and showing me what's what. Being in the booth is quite zen, to be honest. You just get in there with the panel that you're going to be spraying, get the spray gun all hooked up, mask down, and you're just away with your own thoughts, spraying away until you get the job done. And it is quite peaceful. Like, if you do go in there and you do have any negative thoughts or anything like that, you'll come out and leave and you'll be at peace of mind then.
I'm Matthew Coggins and I'm the Deputy Head of Motor Vehicle at Leeds City College. Students come with very little knowledge or some knowledge of how a motor vehicle works, and normally they enter at level 1. We have some students entering at level 2. Level 1 teaches a student everything that's basic about a car, when engine operates, the cooling system, lubrication. We build on that at level 2 with more transmission and electronics thrown in. And then at level 3, it's about diagnosing the fault. So it's the full process from knowing or beginning to know how a car operates through to how to diagnose a faulty system on a vehicle.
The development of the electric vehicle qualification is constantly evolving. The different awarding bodies are introducing different levels that can cater for the needs of the industry. As a college, we're continuously working with these awarding bodies to make sure that the levels that we can offer some of the learners, the students that are attending the course here, are able to get the most up-to-date training for the electric vehicle. And it's not just about the electric vehicle, it's about the hybrid vehicle and other renewable methods of propelling the motor vehicle. The college is constantly looking to upskill the staff and to ensure that the equipment here is all up to date. That just gives the learner that possibility of being able to go into the workshop and be 100% confident with everything that they've been taught on. And there's nothing unfamiliar with what they'll find in industry.
You get people who come to us and they've never picked up a screwdriver before. So we start them off easy with like a 3-pin, 13-amp 3-pin plug that you'd find on any piece of electrical equipment in your home. We take them through lighting circuits, socket circuits, in various different wiring enclosures, such as the conduit and trunking that we've had a look at today. Seeing how the different cables that we use, and then they get the chance to inspect and test, make sure that it's safe to be commissioned. It's a great trade to get into. I mean, the industry at the moment is booming, especially after, you know, recovering from the pandemic. There's just been so much work out there. We've got more apprentices than we've ever had, and we increased the cohort of students by 50% last year. There's a huge difference in students from who come to us in September to when they leave and they finish the course, and whether they're leaving the level 2 course to go into level 3 or whether they're leaving level 3 to go and try and find a job out in industry. We've got to make sure that we build the confidence up and ultimately make them into professional electricians.
I think anyone interested in something related to engineering, there's something here, there's a course here. If you are very academic, there is the BTEC course. equally, if you struggle with academic learning but you want to go down that path, it's still a course that you can do. It's not so difficult that you're just gonna, you know, fall over on the first day. And then if you're not academic and you just want to be doing it with your hands, you've got all of the courses in the workshop here. There's the automotive and mechanical engineering courses that are great for getting onto apprenticeships and straight into work. There's a really nice range of lots of different courses and lots of different professions within engineering.
To see people who aren't that confident come into college and then bloom as they transfer through the year and generate skills and demonstrate the skills that they need to go into the industry. It's a fantastic feeling as a tutor just to see the abilities grow and the confidence grow in that person as well. It's a great feeling. You know you've done your job well when that happens.